100 years ago, the mighty Ottoman Empire came to an end. The 600-year-old Islamic Empire that ruled over much of Southern Europe, the Middle East and North Africa gave way to a new nation, Turkey.
Constantinople was renamed Istanbul.
Some say Turkey's Ottoman past influences the decisions of its current leader, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, whose ambition is to make the country a global force again. With its unique location, Erdogan's sphere of influence spans across continents. So what are his ambitions in Africa? 2005 marked a turning point in Turkey-Africa relations when it received an observer status with the African Union, declaring it the Year of Africa. Back then, Turkey had 12 embassies in Africa and zero airline connections.
Today, there are 44 Turkish embassies on the continent, with Turkish Airlines serving 59 destinations.
In the nearly two decades since, Turkey's capital, Ankara, has rapidly expanded its engagement with the continent through trade, aid, education, and diplomacy. Erdogan's increased presidential power and growing popularity across the Muslim world has given him more influence on the global stage. Islamic solidarity makes up a subtle but important element of Turkey-Africa relations in countries where the West is living a vacuum. In 2011, Muslim leaders in Africa called on Turkey to take on greater role in Islamic education on the continent. Turkey offers an appealing soft power alternative for Africa, different from global superpowers China or Russia. Its geographic position at the crossroads of Europe, Asia and Africa contributes to this influence.
It has control over the straits. It is a transit country for connecting natural gas and oil to world markets. Turkey also has geographical proximity to conflict zones.
Turkey has increased its presence in countries in the Sahel after a series of coups in Mali, Chad, Sudan, Guinea, Burkina Faso, Niger, and Gabon. Some suggest the country is leveraging growing anti-French sentiment, positioning itself as a nation without a colonial past. President Erdogan has even described Turkey as an Afro-Eurasian country.
Türkiye'nin konumunun ona verdiği imkanları kullanmak hevesi dolayısıyla Erdoğan yönetiminde çok yüksek. Dolayısıyla otomatik olarak o arabulucu rolüne aday bir ülke.
Turkey's relationship with Somalia is arguably the most important in Turkey-Africa ties. In 2011, Mr. Erdogan became the first non-African leader to visit Mogadishu in 20 years. Since then, Ankara has opened its largest overseas military base there.
Afrika çok ciddi kaynak sahibi ve Batı ile Çin arasında da Rusya arasında da bu yeni ortaya çıkmış jeopolitik mücadelenin de alanlarından bir tanesi. Afrika'da Türkiye'nin varlığı, Türkiye'nin dünya siyasetindeki etkisini kolaylaştıracak ve güçlendirecek bir unsur olarak algılanıyor Ankara'da.
Outside of the capital, Turkish soldiers train government troops to battle Al-Shabaab militants. Under Erdogan, Turkey has increased its military presence abroad. African states are increasingly acquiring Turkish-made drones to fight armed groups. He's strengthened trade links with China, Russia and India and grown Turkey's diplomatic network, especially in Africa. As Erdogan leads Turkey into its second century, the challenge will be maintaining his influence at home and abroad, balancing its Western alliances and continuing to be a stabilizing force in Africa.